most especially in business or bank. I'm sure that most of you know that what is it. We want for something to be able to understand. We want to get this information. Who can share his opinion about bank? What is bank? What is your
bisa juga ya. Oke. Saya duduk aja. Okay, maybe Ridwan, you can share your opinion maybe. What is bank? Bank? Bank, big bank? Do you know big bank? Yeah, you can see everywhere, yeah. Bank institution beside the street Malioboro, maybe we know in Indonesia, yeah, the aggregate number of bank, yeah, like Mandiri Bank BCA, we know, yeah, all related to the financial system. Okay, yeah, let's we see together, yeah, based on our regulation in our country, yeah, bank is yeah, a business entity. Okay, the keyword here is business. Business. So, yeah, when we run system of bank, finally, yeah, its function to get the profitability. Yeah, because yeah, based on this definition, bank is a business entity, a business. Yeah, or we call it in economic language, we call it by commercialism, commercial. Yeah, all aspect run under commercial, yeah, theory or commercial concept. Yeah, it is possible to collect to get the profitability. Yeah, okay. Well, let's we read together. Yeah, this definition. Maybe from Armada Bank, vocal of Armada Bank. Can you see this definition? Yeah, can you read it? What is bank? Oh, minus yeah, your eye. Yeah. Can you see? Sit down in front of. Ah, okay. Can you see? Okay. Oh yeah. Okay. I'm sorry. It's okay. Maybe Ridwan. You can read this definition.
What is bank? Bank is a business entity, the commerce part of the public in the form of selling and distributing to the public in the form of credit and or other forms in order to improve the standard of living of people at large.
Wait, like British language, yeah. Okay, yeah, thank you, Mr. Ridwan. Yeah, bank is a business entity that collect fund from the public in the form of saving. You know saving? Yeah, saving. Yeah, we save our money. We save our another word of money. Our money, there is no anymore without money. Yeah, we collect, we save, yeah, our money at the bank. Yeah, it is collect by saving. Yeah, we save. So yeah, the money belong to bank or belong to us? It is the question. Okay, the money belong to bank or belong to us as the customer of the bank. Are you sure? Okay, yeah. If you answer, yeah, the money belong to bank is right. Yeah, money belong to us as the customer also right. Yeah, because what? Because bank, its function is intermediary. And I would like to show yeah, you the example of the expense of the bank. Yeah, can raise money of can you get the point? Bank can create money out of nothing. Bank bisa menciptakan uang dari ketiadaan. That's why just now, yeah, I deliver to you, yeah. If I ask you, money that we save to the bank belong to bank or belong to us? If you answer belong to bank, it is right. If you answer belong to us, also right. Yeah, belong to us. It is the reality. Our money we save to the bank. And bank just is a system. Okay, but yeah, the system of the bank, bank can create money out of nothing. By what? By create money from our money that we save to the bank. Are you confused? Okay. But yeah, overall, yeah, bank is yeah very important in our country, nationally, and also globally. Because we know bank is the engine of growth. You know engine? What is engine? Machine. Yeah, like you see here, key driver of economy. But when bank become bankrupt, yeah, our economic growth also will be collapsed, will be broken. That's why bank is very important in our country. Okay, the last my question just now. Why bank yeah collapse, our economic become instability? Kenapa ketika bank itu hancur, ekonomi kita juga langsung hancur? As we know, economic aspect not only financial system, but also the real system, like trading, like mining, you know mining, tambang, what animal, tourism, crypto, financial system, real sector, trading, mining, what's anymore, yeah, investment, okay. But the theory is said when the bank collapse, yeah, our economic also will be instability, will be instable, and that's why just now it is the weakness of the bank. Because bank can create money out of nothing. Bank bisa menciptakan uang dari ketiadaan. What is negative impact? Can you analyze? Our money become? Yeah, become be more. We cannot control it. As we know, the more money, the inflation will be happen. Ketika uang itu semakin banyak, we cannot control yeah the money circulation and the society yeah will be inflation. Or money we can call it by will be depression. That's why we need the central bank. You know, in Indonesia we call by BI. How about OJK? What is the difference between OJK and BI? OJK, Otoritas Jasa Keuangan. Yesterday, yeah, we meet with OJK. Yeah, so, what is the difference between OJK and BI? OJK, yeah, remember 3M. What is it? Mengatur, mengawasi, melindungi, mengatur, mengawasi, melindungi, ya, mengatur to regulate how the financial institution run. It is the OJK function. But ya, OJK cannot control how money run. Ya, bagaimana uang itu bisa berjalan? OJK there is not control, cannot control. It is the domain of the BI. It is the difference between BI and OJK. Yeah, that's why we need BI, yeah, Bank of Indonesia or Central Bank to control our money circulation. Yeah, our money volatility, perputaran uang. Because we know, yeah, the more money in the society, yeah, our money will be depreciated. You know depreciate, appreciate and depreciate. Depreciate, no?
No.
Yeah, depreciate or in other word we can say the power of purchasing. Power of purchasing.
Kemampuan dari uang untuk purchasing.
Because what? Because money be more in this society. Jadi semakin banyak uang itu semakin gak bagus. Ya, yeah, it is the formula. Ya, yeah, the formula in economic. Who make it? Do you know? Ada yang tahu siapa yang membuat formula itu? Masa lupa. Irving Fisher. Ya, yeah, ya, yeah, with the theory of quantity of money, ya, yeah, the theory of quantity of money. Okay, let's we continue our materi, ya. Yeah. Okay, yeah, from the definition above, ya, yeah, there are three assignment or three tasks of the bank. The first is collecting, ya, yeah, fund from the public. The second, distributing fund to the public. And the third, providing payment traffic and money circulation services. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Like just now we agree together. So, yeah. Conclusion is what is bank function? Bank function. Fungsi bank itu apa? Collecting and distributing funding and lending in the middle. Bridge as a bridge, or we call it as facilitator. If we use financial system, we call it by. Okay, let's see here as intermediary. Yeah, what is intermediary? An intermediary is one who stand between two other parties. Yeah. Bank are as financial intermediary. If we call it by a bridge, it is just analogy. Yeah, facilitator, it is generally word. Yeah, we can use it every time. But if we use financial system, yeah, it's called it by intermediary. Intermediary, yeah. An institution that operate between a server, yeah, who deposit money in a bank and borrower who receive loan from that bank. Yeah, all the fund deposit are mainly in one big pool, which is then loaned out. Yeah, ditabung kemudian dipinjamkan kembali. Yeah, so we can, yeah, see here together the figure. Yeah. Saver, funding, yes, now, yeah. The process when bank collect money from the public, we call it by funding, yeah. When bank distribute the money, yeah, to the borrower or to the public who need the money, we call it by lending, yeah. It is the financial system language, yeah. Financial system statement, yeah. Funding and lending. Yeah, the general would we can yeah change it with the collecting or distributing. Okay, I think this about just in diksi, yeah, diction of the word, yeah. Okay, let's we discuss together about conventional banking concept and system. Okay, ya, yeah. Bisa dilihat ini kabur, ya. Yeah. Mohon maaf ini. Ya. Okay, ya. Yeah. Like I explained before, yeah, conventional bank here also its function as intermediary from the servers, yeah, until to the borrowers, and the bank its position in the middle as facilitator. The server deposit their money, and also the server can withdraw. Withdrawal, you know, withdraw. menarik ya, to take ya, to take their money every time ya, every time, every day, every month, every years, every minute, yang penting saldonya ada. Yeah. If there is no saldo, it is the problem. Yeah. You can call satpam. Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah. The next question is, how is the operation of the bank? When the money, yeah, already stand at the bank. So the question is, how is the operation? Yeah. Generally, if we use conventional banking concept and system, yeah, it is very simple. Yeah, conventional bank just use the instrument of loan. Do you know loan? Laundry? Oh yeah, loan. Yeah. But if we call it in financial system, we mention it by credit. However, credit also for every bank, yeah, but when we use it English, it will be credit. But if we use bahasa or the logical of Indonesian people, credit is minjam, loan ya, borrow, we borrow the money. Okay, so the next question, how is the bank process to get the profitability? How is the process? Maybe one or some of you can deliver the opinion. Gimana caranya? Ya.
Ini bisa menginvestasi investment, bisa buat pinjam bunga, bisa
apa? Ya, oke, very good, appropriate one. Ya, yeah. The keyword here is the flower, bunga ya. Yeah. But if we use financial system is interest. Okay, ya. However, ya, in philosophy of economic, bunga or interest not only interest but also usury. Maybe from Unida, no, ya. What is different between interest and usury? In Islamic perspective, usury is prohibited, but interest is debatable. Ada yang mengatakan boleh. Ya, some ulama Islam secular interest is possible. But I think, ya, if use fatwa, ya, in Indonesia, both interest or usury is unlawful, not lawful, ya, unlawful, prohibited. Okay, ya, it is just tambahan saja, additional insight for you, ya. Okay, very good, Mr. Ridwan, ya. So, yeah, how is the bank get the profitability from interest rate? Interest rate, tingkat bunga. Maybe we can hear, you can see here, interest payment when the bank obligation, must to pay, interest to the savers. Misalkan 10%. Example just 10%. But when bank lend the loan to the borrower, bank determine the interest rate is 12%. So the question, how much the profitability of the bank? ketika bank memberikan bunga kepada nasabah yang menabung 10%, kemudian bank menetapkan bunga kepada yang meminjam 12%, berapa keuntungan bank di sini? 2%. Very simple. Ya. Ya. Very simple. So the profitability of the bank here is just 2%. Ya, the higher interest rate, the higher profitability that bank can get it. But we know ya, the services ya. Also very very much ya from the bank facilities ya, like transaction ya, transferring ya, every customer has to buy. It is also the way how bank can get profitability. Jadi bukan hanya pinjam meminjam saja, jadi banyak fasilitas-fasilitas yang diberikan oleh bank kepada nasabah melalui layanan jasa, transfer segala macam. Jadi bank ini luar biasa, ya. So I just now read here, bank can create money out of nothing. Ya, bank bisa menciptakan uang dari ketiadaan. It's very, ya. Very what you say, very great, yeah. But also very dangerous for our stability in economic area. Nah, that's why, yeah. Banking, yeah, system in a country must under control central bank. Yeah, central bank has to regulate to control. Ya, to remember, to remind. Ya, in other bank, commercial bank run with ya greed carefully. Nah, kehati-hati. And we now, maybe one or some of you can share his reading. Maybe we now, ya. Many time our economic crisis happen from the bank, determined from the bank. Crisis, you know, crisis, economic contagion, guncangan ekonomi, yeah, mostly from the bankrupt of the bank. That's why, yeah, we have to make more stable the bank system. As we know, the one solution is Islamic financial system, yeah. And also in Islamic economic, yeah, discuss about Islamic bank. Because what? Because conventional bank, yeah, not only unlawful in normative perspective, but also very dangerous for the stability of economy. Okay, maybe just now, like I said, yeah, conventional bank is very dangerous. Can you analyze what is determined or what is the factor? Kenapa bank konvensional itu berbahaya? Yeah, as we know just now, yeah, the phenomena, the reality, and the data say, yeah, the crisis of economic, yeah, mostly determined by conventional bank, not only nationally but also globally. Like subprime mortgage happened at America, not at Kulon Progo, yeah. Yeah, 28. Yeah, happen economic crisis globally, and our country, yeah, one of the victim of conventional economic system, yeah, contagion from America. Okay, maybe one or some of you can deliver what the factor, what determine why conventional bank very dangerous. Ada yang bisa menjelaskan kira-kira? You can continue like I said, that I mentioned just now. It is our study.
Bank can create money out of commission. Yeah, because conventional banking is not based on. Okay, it's very yeah. But of course, in real economy, mostly conventional bank can yeah, focus in non-real economy. Non-real. Yeah. Kenapa di non-real? We know economic area
divide into two area. The first area is real sector. Real sector, do you know real sector? Like trading in the market, real, we can face to the trader, to the seller, real. Mining, tambang, investment, yeah, tourism, it is the real sector. Yeah. The second area is non-real sector. What is the example? Ada yang tahu area yang non-real? Like forex, do you know forex? Foreign exchange, palas-palas valuta, asik. Oh ini kan trading gitu ya, trading palas. In area banking we call it by in Indonesia ya, PUAP, do you know PUAP? Nah, nanti yang tahu panjangan PUAP saya kasih duit 100.000. Singkatan, ayo. PUAP. Ya, saya kasih waktu 3 detik. 1, 2, 3. Oke. Kita MS over. PUAP is pasar uang antar bank. Pasar uang antar bank. Bagaimana sistemnya bekerja? How does ya its system work? BNI nggak punya uang pinjam ke Mandiri. Mandiri nggak punya uang pinjam ke BCA. Kalau BNI collapse, Mandiri juga pasti collapse. Semuanya akan bangkrut. Inilah kita sebut sebagai sistemik antar. Kenapa BNI pinjam? Karena BNI nggak punya duit ketika nasabahnya ingin ngambil uang secara bersamaan. Pura-pura punya duit, akhirnya dia pinjam ke Mandiri. That's why ya apa? The ghost, do you know ghost? Ya. Yang paling ditakuti oleh bank itu adalah bank panik atau bank run. Do you know what is panic of bank of or bank run? Ketika nasabah mengambil uangnya di saat yang sama dengan jumlah yang sangat besar. Ada nggak duitnya di bank? Nah, ini bonus bagi yang hadir
langsung. Berapa disalurkan ke sektor real gitu ya atau sektor penting katakanlah euro wajib minimumnya 10% 10% maka cadangan kita meskipun berapa nah itu malah yang diperboleh kita berapa 4.500 duitnya sisa berapa ya ketika ribuan kawan-kawan yang punya duitnya ada di biasanya mereka mengambil pinjam utang. Ketika itu Asumsi yang terbaik berapa? Tingkat bunga 100.000 menjadi yang terbaik berapa? 500.000. Ini asumsi yang kembali karena berbeda. Baik, this is how much.
How much money? 5,500 or 4,000.
The total of money here is 10,500. Inilah yang saya sebagai uang hanya 5.000 secara real tiba-tiba dalam sekejap mata berubah menjadi 10.500 nilai sebagai money ilusi yang tidak ada, yang sebenarnya tidak ada, tidak apa ada inflasi bukan inflasi. Kalau bank bisa dikontrol, bank akan menciptakan instability of economy. Kenapa kamu bisa melakukan dengan uang? Karena ada buku. Nah, so, yeah, the keyword here or the factor here is the interest. Interest can create money of economic condition. Bunga itu bisa menunjukkan ekonomi di mana tadi terlibat berdasarkan uang secara otomatis. That's why we have to change our system into Islamic one. Because what? Because Islamic banking system, cannot receive interest system. Because interest is prohibited. Ada yang hafal dalilnya? Yamhaqullahu riba wa yurbi soda sodaqat wallahu la yuhibbu kulla kafarin asim. Masih banyak dalil-dalil yang lain. That's why we have to establish the Islamic banking. We have to build Islamic system. Because what? We know Islamic is justice. Nah, bagaimana keadilan itu bekerja? Let's we discuss here. Okay, Islamic bank. We agree. Also, its function as intermediary. From this effort. We call it not borrower but customer. Nasabah yang perlu gitu ya, bukan borrower karena produknya bukan kredit, tetapi there are many product from Islamic banking like musyaraka, mudaroba, murabaha, istisna, salam, ijarah mumtah ya ditambi. There are three product ya. Profit and loss sharing, trading and leasing. Ada tiga produk daripada Islamic banking. And the core here, interest is prohibited in Islamic bank. Because just now, interest is riba. And riba is unlawful in Islam. Not only in Al-Quran, but also in al-hadis Rasulullah prohibit. Allah also prohibit, not only Allah, not only Rasulullah, but also the philosoph like Aristoteles, Herbert Spencer, semua para filosof juga melarang riba. Because what? Because riba micro or macro area is very dangerous. Back levelnya mikro, apalagi makro.
ya, akan menciptakan economic contagion. What do you know economic contagion? Guncangan ekonomi, like crisis, recession, depression, ya, and the others. Nah, that's why ya we need Islamic one. Ya, so the question is how is the Islamic banking work? Ada yang tahu bagaimana bank Islam itu bekerja? Nah, oke okay, ya, very excellent ya, properly done ya. Bagi hasil. In language, English language, we call it by profit and loss, eh? Sharing, bagi hasil. Jadi, bukan hanya sebatas bagi hasil. But the grand theory here, grand theory-nya, fokus teorinya adalah Islamic bank cannot create money. Ya, yeah, you get the point? Islamic bank cannot create money out of profit. Unlike conventional one, conventional can pay money out of deposit because conventional is interest as well. So, yeah, create money out of deposit secara otomatis. Unlike tidak sama Islamic bank, yeah, cannot create money in those one because the result hasilnya depend on the situation. Di akhir baru akan ketahuan untung apa rugi. If we get the profit, we have to share our profit between bank and customer. If we get the loss, we have to divide our loss between bank and the customer. Bagi hasil dan bagi rugi. Nah, profit and loss sharing ini hitung-hitungannya di akhir, bukan di awal. Berbeda dengan bunga tadi. Bunga dihitungnya mana? Di awal. Itulah perbedaan very fundamental itu. And you have to know about this concept. So, yeah, Allah prohibit riba not only about instrument, not only discuss about, yeah, instrument, yeah. Actually, Allah want to show us, yeah, riba is as a system. Riba itu sebagai sistem, dia bukan sebagai produk, bukan sebagai instrument, yeah. Nah, karena dia sistem, so its impact is very great, very big, ya, yeah, until can make the economy, ya, yeah, not stable anymore, tidak bisa lagi stabil dan seterusnya. Kenapa? Karena selalu terguncang tadi dengan keadaan yang penuh ketidakpastian, uncertainty situation because of the interest system, ya. Yeah. And that's why we need Islamic banking concept and system, ya. Yeah. Oke, okay. Let we now together here. What is the differences between Islamic bank and conventional? From the risk, ya. Yeah. Islamic bank, all the risk, ya, yeah, face together. All the risk can be shared. Semua resiko dibagi, ya, yeah, dibagi sama, ya, yeah, sama rata. Unlike conventional the risk just belong to the customer. Ya, resikonya hanya diserahkan kepada nasabah. Misalkan Ridwan pinjam sama bank Mandiri 10 juta, bunganya 10%. Bank enggak mau tahu mau rugi mau untung, Ridwan harus kembali berapa? 11 juta kan? Iya kan? Rugi atau un, it is we call it by shifting. Do you know shifting? Shifting, transferring the risk to others, to other parties. So, yeah, it is injustice. Yeah, tidak adil. As we know, if we want to run business together, if we face the risk, yeah, must be shared together. Kalau kita menjalankan bisnis, kita menghadapi risiko, maka risikonya kita bagi sama rata. Jangan kita lempar risikonya kepada yang lain. Nah, that's why ya, yeah, Islamic bank ya, yeah, face the risk together. The risk will be shared. And from surveillance system ya, yeah, Islamic bank the existence of a Syariah supervisory board to ensure ya, yeah, that bank operation do not divide. Jadi ada pengawasnya di sini. Unlike conventional, there is no supervisory board. Especially based on the values yang bergantung dengan nilai-nilai kemanusiaan. Kayak tadi itu ada nggak nilai-nilai keadilannya di situ? There is no. Conventional bank just depend on the system. Bagaimana sistem itu bekerja. Unlike Islamic bank based on the wisdom. What is the wisdom? Kebijaksanaan. Or mostly in Islamic economic diction, we call it by al-maslaha. Al-maslaha. Okay, next business framework. Islamic bank based on Holy Al-Quran and As-Sunnah. We know together all activities must be Sharia compliant. Conventional or traditional bank based on secular principle. We know secular. There is no Islamic values here. There is no religiosity values here. And there is no the humanity consideration. Tidak ada pertimbangan kemanusiaan. Interest charging. Islamic bank financing not interest based like I explained just now. Conventional bank based on interest. And we know interest riba is prohibited. Interest on deposit. Islamic bank do not receive fixed interest. Depositor take part in the profit and loss sharing. If we save our money with wadiah transaction, it is not interest. We call it by bonus. Kalau kita menabung dengan wadiah, titipan di bank syariah namanya bukan bagi hasil, tapi namanya bonus, ada tambahan. Konsekuensinya bonus itu tidak pasti, not fixed rate. So depend on the banks manager. Risk sharing in equity financing. Islamic bank offer musharakah as mean of equity financing. Dina musharakah profit and loss sharing. If we get the profit from our business, me and the bank get together the profit based on our red equity. Ada lagi mudharabah segala macamnya Conventional bank only offer crowd investment PIM and venture capital Hambatannya restriction all activities must be syariah compliant and legal and conventional one activities must be legal. Jadi hanya legal saja from our positive law regulation, not from syariah compliant. Kalau riba di dalam hukum positif kita boleh-boleh saja kan. But we are Muslim. Our references is Al-Quran and Al-Hadis. We know Allah prohibited riba in Al-Quran and Al-Hadis. That's why riba is unlawful. Nah, ini lanjutan Apa bedanya interest dengan profit and loss sharing? Interest calculated from the principal money lent. Yes now Profit and loss sharing calculated from the profit. Ketika ada untung, kalau nggak ada untung ya sudah nggak dapat apa-apa. The second, interest change according to the market condition. Jadi perubahan itu tergantung dengan fluktuasi pasar. Jadi bunga yang 10% tadi itu bisa berubah loh. Sometimes become 20%, sometimes become 7% based on situation. Nah, ini dampaknya begini kawan-kawan, saya ingin jelaskan.
Misalkan saya beli motor harga 10 juta. Dia belinya sama motor profesional. Kata motor profesional bunganya 10% Dalam waktu 1 tahun saya membeli 11 10% ini bisa naik turun tergantung dari ketetapan bunga dari bank sentral. Kalau saya menggunakan bank syariah, saya beli motor 10 juta. Saya ngajukan pembiayaan ke bank syariah nantinya sama-sama 10%. Berapa kalau saya angsur sampai total 1 tahun kemudian? 11 juta. Bedanya di mana? Kita jadi takut first dengan profesional dan Islam. Sama-sama pinjam, saya pinjam ke bank profesional 10 juta, tingkat bunganya 10%. Bank saya tingkat marginnya 10%. Ayo, ada yang bisa menjawab?
Mohon maaf terjadi di masyarakat kita. So, I think we have to educate our society. Ini kawan-kawan yang alumni Summer School of Ideals, you are duta of Islamic Economic and Finance. Now you have to explain to the public, to the society, to the people that Islamic bank is very different with conventional. Apalagi di bank Islam itu kan ada bagi hasil. Nah, bagi hasil ini paling penting itu ikonnya. Kenapa ikon? Meskipun ini enggak marketable ya, masyarakat kita belum siap berbagi hasil. Padahal the DNA or the identity of Islamic bank is look at profit and loss. Terletak pada profit and loss sharing. Kenapa? Karena dengan profit and loss sharing, Islamic bank system can create money. Just bank Islam itu nggak bisa menciptakan uang. Dia tergantung aja. Nggak bisa tiba-tiba berubah menjadi 10.500 kayak profit. Boleh saya katakan, ini siapa kita kita ini bank berapa? 5.500. Semakin tinggi bunganya, semakin rendah cadangan ada di sini, semakin banyak uang yang ada. Ini bahas banyak yang kita. Ini hadiah untuk kawan-kawan yang ikut program Summer School of Ideals. That's why we have to build Islamic banking. To make what? To make our economic more stable. More stable. And we agree just now, our banking system is the machine of economic growth. Jadi perlu distabilkan. By what? By managing the system of financial. Especially management of banking operational. Okay, the last one, I think. Sudah jam 5. Okay. Financing mode in Islamic system, Profit and loss sharing, its transaction like mudarabah, musyarakah, Implanting di ar musaqqat muzara'ah ini di pertanian ya, perkebunan ada musaqqat muzara'ah. However, in Islamic banking at Indonesia, we never get musaqqat and muzara'ah. Karena enggak laku gitu ya. Kemudian yang non profit and loss sharing qardu hasa. Ya, baik muajjal ini ya mostly popular by murabah. Ya. Baik assalam ya also not marketable, not popular. Whereas we know baik assalam is according to my opinion is solution for the farmer. Padahal ini solusi bagi para petani. Nah, kenapa kok ini selalu minus? Ah, bukan minus ya, nol. Not marketable. Nggak laku. Nah, ini masalah psikologis. Petani kita malu masuk kantor-kantor bank yang terlalu mewah. So, we need the other strategy in marketing. We promote ya this product to the farmers with ya humanist or persuasive strategy ya murabahah ya dan seterusnya. Ini yang tapi di Indonesia yang terkenal hanya mudharabah musyarakah. Kemudian dijual belinya ada murabahah, salam dan istisna. Ya istisna to make the house financing ya mostly use istisna transaction. Jadi inilah bedanya Islamic bank and conventional. If conventional just one instrument, what just now? Credit and credit based on interest. Ya, yeah, we know interest is riba. Riba in Islamic perspective is prohibited. Ya, yeah. That's why we have to to promote the other product ya beside credit yes now because credit riba is haram in Islamic banking ya we provide many product ya profit and loss sharing divide into many product like mudharabah musyarakah mujaroah musaqqat ya at non profit and loss sharing or in trading. We call it by murabahah, ada jual beli kan. Misalkan kita ingin membeli rumah, akadnya apa? Jual beli namanya murabahah atau istisna atau istisna. Kalau kita ingin berbisnis akadnya apa? Bagi hasil skemanya mudharabah boleh, musyarakah juga boleh. Kalau musyarakah bank punya duit, kita punya duit. Jadi sifatnya setara. Our position horizontally. Ya. But if we use mudharabah scheme, ya, all money from the bank. All money from the bank. We are just as so mudharib or manager. For example, I have business. What business? Saya punya bisnis kafe misalkan kan. Saya punya pasar saya mahasiswa. UMY ini 27.000 mahasiswa. Nanti mahasiswa yang enggak belanja ke KP saya kasih nilai C semua. Kan pasarnya besar kan? Wah, artinya disetujuin sama bank. Akhirnya bank pool biayanya. Saya yang mengelola sebagai manajer. Dijalankan selama 1 tahun misalkan atau 1 bulan atau 6 bulan untuk bank nanti 60%, keuntungannya untuk saya 40%. Itu namanya red bagi hasil atau nisbah. Tuh ya. Kalau rugi gimana? Ya itu namanya resiko bisnis. Saya hilang bisnis saya, reputasi saya juga hilang. Bank kehilangan kepercayaan, bank kehilangan duitnya. Jadi sama-sama rugi. Adil nggak kira-kira? Adil. Ya, unlike conventional loan, conventional bank just use credit based on interest. Untung atau tidak untung nasabahnya harus ngembalin uang lebih banyak. Nah, itu secara akad tadi ya. Secara sistem conventional bank can create money out of losing. Oke, ya. Oke, I think that's all our materi today. Maybe one or some of you want to deliver the question, please. Ada yang ingin bertanya? Maybe yang from online, maybe online participant. You can use your Arabic maybe from Unida. Betul. Di atas al-bilugal arabiyah. Jarib jawab kajalika bilugal arabiyah. Perubama satas al-an al-bang al-islami di munasabati mudorobah. Ya. Kaipa ya, mudorobah tapal di bangkil Islam. Ma parkun baina bangkil Islami wa bang al-Gharbi. Masalan katalik aswa. Nanti ada hadiahnya UMI Tirta di bawah kau kita. Ada pertanyaan? Tidak ada? Oke okay, ya, very clear ya.
Ya. Kalau misalnya teman-teman menjadikan kerja ya Pak, teman-teman menjadikan orang yang juga terus gimana Pak? Pinjam orang gagal.
Iya, itu yang bahaya. Makanya bank itu kan punya rasio namanya NPL.
Apa itu NPL? Non performing loan. Kalau perpesona namanya NPL. Atau bahaya apa namanya? Berarti Pak. Kalau misalnya kalau ada yang
macam-macam terlihat
itu ya
cuma cita iya cuma kalau kurang masih kurang
nggak hitung-hitungannya pasti selalu lebih. Misalkan Mas Ridwan ingin pinjam 100 juta jaminannya harus lebih daripada 100 juta misalkan kayak sertifikat tanah di atas misalkan sertifikat tanah itu harganya sekarang kalau dijual tanah 150 juta. Maksimal Mas Ridwan hanya pinjam 100 juta saja. Jadi 50 jutanya sebagai cadangan. Karena nanti semakin hari nilai dipinjamkan itu semakin bertambah harusnya. Jadi untuk menjaga daya beli uang yang kita pinjamkan. Nah, jadi misalkan Mas Ridwan enggak mampu bayar selama 1 tahun, 100 juta bangkrut, udah sertifikatnya diambil. Nanti dilelang nanti tanahnya dijual laku 100 juta ya sudah ada lebihnya itu jadi hak milik bank. Tapi kalau syariah ya tadi kalau pinjam gitu ya kan nggak ada pinjam atau jual beli motor tadi ya kan ngajuin ke bank syariah harganya 10 juta kita sudah siap nih ingin ngangsur tiap bulan sampai 1 tahun kan pokoknya di 11 juta kan. Tiba-tiba kita nggak mau bayar, jangan kan bayar beli bensin itu nggak bisa. Gimana caranya?